This year, what we're doing here is actually just hits, and then semifinals, and then the finals, obviously, sports day. So the guys have a lot ahead in terms of work to get onto the first day house teams, and then obviously to the intercol team, and we do it by standards. So you have to achieve that standard and thing, so you can move into the next level. Everyone would have remembered our performances last year at Intercol and in track and field in general. So we're gonna build on that, build on those performances. Nothing special, but we always do what we can to compete and keep up pace with the other schools that we are not as big a school as other schools that have larger populations than us. But we are here to compete. We're gonna be doing our best, just as we did 2016 and before. We had a few minor errors last year. We had to work on rectifying with the boys. Also, we have a few guys nursing injuries coming from football and so on. You know how hectic the school term is, really. So we want to get those things dealt with first, and then we can maybe make a full assessment. But in terms of performance, we expect nothing but the best from our boys at every event, every activity that we're going to be attending.
This year?
Well, of course, seniors. If you look at the large gatherings at prep, juniors, and our form five, this year we have two guys that are senior, just two students. And you're looking at Intercol, two boys have to put on that performance for the entire 3 days next year. You have two boys doing all those events. So, I mean, it's not something that we are very strong in, and we know that. So, obviously, we compensate in the other categories. We try to build those categories, something that we probably would not have for a few years. Seniors is not something we're going to have. All boys graduate at 16, 17, so we don't have seniors per se. But we obviously, as I said, we work on the other categories to make up for that weak area.
And in terms of the athletics program at the Presentation Brothers College, what are some of the plans in the pipeline in terms of getting the young athletes involved in not only track but field events? Over the holidays we had the pole vault exercise and so on.
Well, we have been participating at the Grenadier Athletics Association have this developmental meet that they have every 2 or 3 weeks. So we have been participating each and every one of them. We've been there. Our boys been training since July, getting their fitness up. I think the pole vault would have been for most senior athletes, but not really, our boys are young. So I think they would have selected most senior athletes to maybe learn the thing. Which, I mean, sometimes it's good, but maybe developing the younger boys come up might have been a different approach they could have taken, but I'm not sure what the intention is, so I'm not criticizing. But as I said, we are here, we look at the field events, we have developed them in our preps. And one of the things we have changed is the structure of our PE program at the school. And we have implemented a few things, implementing different areas, additional areas as well, the way we do the classes and everything. So we have a different approach to physical education that is really paying off. And last year was the first fruits being bared from that program. So we expect the best from the boys, and we expect the best from the school in general. We have a number of talented athletes, and I don't want to stand here and talk about just two. But In terms of Shemar, Shemar is one of our most senior athletes. He's not a senior, but he's one of our most senior athletes. Well, I mean, he's been prepared. He's one of the guys that's, I mean, in terms of coming off a serious injury from last year. So he's just kind of taking it slowly. But hopefully he's okay and he can compete at the school sports.
Well, I'm being honest with you. I'm injured right now, so I'm not too good on the training. And I'm trying. Every day I go in training, but you know, with the injury, I had to kind of relax.
Looking back on the 2016 season, summarize that season for us. You had quite a good season, both in Intercol and at the school sports meet.
Well, I would say that year was my best year so far because I went training every day. I worked out, I focused, and I would say overall it's the best season I had in my life so far, and I'm looking forward to do better.
Well, what are your expectations for the season coming?
My expectations are the same as last year, to dominate the 100 and 200 meters and the relay, hopefully, and to get champion.
You have your brother with you at the school. How much of a motivation is it for either you or him having each other to compete with, or probably train together?
Well, I would say it's very complicated because sometimes he doesn't want to go training, sometimes I don't want to go training, but then we motivate each other, we try to like work with each other so that we could get a benefit out, like, you understand? So pretty much it's a nice thing because we have our competition, our rivalry, and well, every day we train, and it's kind of tough because my brother, he always competing with me, and even though I'm injured, I'm still working my best just to beat him, you understand? And he's working his best to beat me, you understand? So I would say it's a very good rivalry, I would say.
And between the two of you, who's the fastest?
I would say I'm the fastest, yeah, because I'm older, you understand? So yeah, but he's doing good, he's doing very good. This year he has to run against some athletes that are gifted, really gifted, and I'll have to say good luck to those guys and good luck to my brother, because it's tough.
How has preparation been going thus far for the 2017 athletic season?
Well, I find it's been going great. Well, I haven't had no pain or anything from last year's injury, but I'm working harder than ever because I know this year I'll have a lot of tough competitors, and I would like to win champion, and I would also like to be the first sub-junior to break the 11th finish line. Well, in primary school, we didn't realize we were so low until, because we used to just run for fun, but our auntie and other persons saw potential in us. So we started doing running more seriously. And then I think this year, well, my brother is one of the fastest persons I have ever run with. It's kind of hard to keep up with him in a 100 and thing because he has a lot of power. And that kind of training, every day I try to train with him and go my follow up, because if I can beat him, then I should be able to have a chance, like, against the rest of the competition.